if we could continue from where we left off. So, for the jury. So, if I could have the jury's attention, please. What we are going to do in this case, there is a dispute over excessive entanglement and whether this is an excessive entanglement or not. What that means is that case law does not allow public funds to go to religious institutions to pay teachers at religious institutions to teach religion. Okay? However, on the other side of that, education law requires that the public institution provide a free and appropriate education, also known as FAPE. Okay? If you find, this is for the jury, if you find that the public institution has not provided a free and appropriate education for the defendant, then the money, then the school must pay for his tuition to the private religious school, regardless. The reason for that is it's not public funds. It's not public funds going to a religious institution for the purpose then of promoting a religion. It's public funds going to a religious institution because the public institution was found to have not been doing its job, which primarily was to provide an education that was free and appropriate. So those are your standards, okay? You may decide as a jury whether the education was free and appropriate as you decide whether to award tuition for to the defendant for the purpose of attending the private religious institution. Does that make sense to the jury? Okay. If the witness would please retake the stand, we can finish questioning. Were we finished with questioning?
No, I was redirecting.
She's
yeah.
On redirect. Yep.
Okay. So, were your purposes on sending your daughter to St. Joseph Academy for the promotion of religious study?
No. Going to St. Joseph Academy was our only option after what happened to my daughter after she was so horrendously treated at
Okay, thank you very much. You may step down. Does the plaintiff have any other witnesses at this time?
No.
So the plaintiff rests, correct? Yes, okay. It will be the defense's turn to present their case, and they may call their first witness. Do you promise to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
Okay.
Counselor may proceed.
So why did you call Alex into your office?
I noticed that she was having poor attendance and poor grades.
And what did Alex do when you asked her if she was having problems in school?
She kind of just played it off and shrugged her shoulders at first.
And then after that, what did you do?
Yes.
Who is this?
This is Justin. Sid's not here, so I'm like filling in.
Yeah.
This is who?
Oh, okay. That makes so much more sense.
Justin
Cook. Yeah, we thought we were doing CJ's.
Who's Justin?
Okay.
Yeah.
Are we okay though? We do have a fill in because
yeah,
yes.
Sid's gone.
Because Sid's gone. Okay. Can we work with this?
Sure.
Okay, yes, you may proceed then.
And then after that, what did she do?
She just became extremely agitated and fidgety. She raised her voice and said that she wanted to drop out of KHS.
And did you do anything about the situation?
I told her to calm down, take a deep breath, and explain from the beginning why she felt like this.
Did you talk to any other teachers about the situation?
I emailed the principal telling her what was going on. That seemed to make her feel a lot better.
Can we enter the minutes?
Yes. What? Okay, and that is page. Okay, so we're asking page 45. Page 45, we are looking at Exhibit F, email correspondence between Justine Cook and Brenda Lee. And does the plaintiff have any objections to Exhibit F being entered into evidence? No objections? Then Exhibit F will be entered into evidence for the purpose of the case. You may proceed.
Okay, so what did Principal Lee say about the situation?
She explained that Pearson had been suspended, but that she had been doing a lot better and was on a straight path. And she said that not to worry too much about it, because it was just high schoolers, and that happens all the time. So she didn't really think very much of it.
What have you done to help stop bullying KHS?
Well, I'm a member of the KHS committee, and so I helped write the bullying policy. And everyone on the committee agreed that bullying outside of school was not KHS's problem.
Did the plaintiff have any cross-examination questions for
yes.
this witness? You may proceed.
You mentioned a bullying policy. Is this the bullying policy?
Bullying policy on page 43. Yes. Exhibit D, does the defense have any... was it already submitted?
Was already submitted
into evidence.
Yeah.
So you may use
wow.
Exhibit D.
Okay. Are you aware that in the bullying policy, it states that the principal is required to conduct a prompt and thorough investigation of each alleged bullying incident that is reported to him or her? Are you aware that the principal in the statement is required to conduct a prompt and thorough investigation of each alleged bullying incident that is reported to him or her?
Yes, I would agree with that.
Email with the principal, shouldn't it have been a requirement to talk to CJ or Alex due to the bullying that she mentioned that was happening in school?
In my meeting with Alex, I told her to contact me again if the problem worsened or continued, and she did not contact me, so I assumed that everything resolved itself.
But that doesn't change the fact that the principal was still required, as in your statement that you and the principal wrote, to conduct a thorough investigation of the bullying that had happened. It was more of a statement than a question, but regardless.
That would be your objection.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Shoot, that's an objection.
No, well, they can object because you stated something, you didn't ask a question.
Too late.
Can I rephrase that?
Yes. But that's what would happen is an objection, and then it would say, could you restate as, yeah, you'd use a question.
Should the principal have contacted CJ or Alex due to this being a alleged bullying incident?
Yes, that she should have.
Okay.
No further questions.
Thank you very much. Would you like to redirect? Do we want to switch it up right now?
She's trying to be me.
Yeah, she's trying to be you. Do you want to go ahead and take the stand and we'll just switch it? We were running out of time and we had to get somebody up there. So, you ready for this?
I hope so.
Okay.
So did you ever talk to CJ about the situation?
Yeah, I did. I called her in my office. Wait. Let me just look through my stuff first. That's okay.
Okay.
I'll just take 30 seconds. I need to organize my work. Wait.
So did you ever talk with CJ about the situation?
Yeah, I did. After Alex came in and asked me and told me about what happened, I went and called CJ to my office and told her to stop.
Okay. Hey, hold on a second. What were you gonna ask?
Was that it?
That was me.
Well, yeah, because they already asked questions, cross-examined, and then there was... This was the redirect.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. So it ended up being really short. Sorry about that. Oh, okay. Does the... Does the defense have another witness? You may proceed. Oh, do you promise to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
Oh,
you may proceed.
You didn't ask me because you knew I was going to tell the truth.
I didn't ask because I asked the old you before the new you.
What is your role at KHS?
Who is this? We need to just address the people as they said it.
This is
Brenda.
Well, nobody said it, so.
So that's where usually the lawyer will ask, can you state your name and occupation for the record, please? But
don't they
have to
spell it?
Oh, they did in the video because it was Canada. Okay, are we ready? Okay, you may proceed.
So what is your role at King High School?
I am the principal.
And how long have you worked in the education administration?
I've been working in administration for 10 years.
And have you had any problems with CJ?
The principal at the junior high told me that he had been causing some trouble in his experience, but when he came to school, I gave him a talking to that wouldn't be tolerated anymore.
Would that be hearsay?
Go ahead and explain.
Because they never saw CJ being bad. They never had any witness of CJ being bad. They just have the teacher or the principal saying it could be.
Wait, are we talking about CJ?
Yeah, we're talking about CJ.
They have records.
It's a journal week,
but they have records of his.
So your testimony is that someone came to tell you somebody told you about what CJ had done, correct?
Yeah.
Okay. So, no, that's okay. So yes, you could say that that's hearsay because she didn't hear it from CJ herself, and because she didn't see it happen, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so yes, that could be hearsay. So could you rephrase your question so that she could answer more clearly?
Since the new school year, have you had any issues with CJ?
No. So far, CJ has been on the straight and narrow. He's a good student.
And what has Billings' family done to fix the problem?
Mrs. Billings came into my office on December 2nd and started screaming and complaining about me for not responding to the bullying. And I tried to talk her down so we could have a conversation about it before she screamed at me some more and left to go withdraw from school.
So what do you think about the bullying policy?
I think it is completely adequate, and it is used whenever alleged bullying is reported. It covers from offensive, fear of physical harm, and emotional distress.
And where did the text messages and MyFace posts occur?
Outside of school grounds, since phones are not allowed to be on the school grounds, the texting. And MyFace isn't allowed to be on any of the school computers.
So have measures been taken by the school to prevent this?
Yes.
Should the school be responsible?
No. When Alex came in, we tried to deal with it as best as we could, but since it occurred off school grounds, we're limited in how we can respond.
No further questions.
Thank you. Does the defense have any cross-examination questions, or the plaintiff have any cross-examination questions for this witness?
Yes.
You may proceed.
Did you help write the current bullying policy at KHS?
I did. I was on the team that.
Are you aware that CJ was sending threatening messages on school grounds?
Ms. Durham Cook did email me when Alex was called into her office.
Are you aware that you, as the principal, are required to look into any alleged bullying allegations? In the bullying policy that you helped write?
Yes.
Did you follow up and talk to CJ?
As mentioned in the email, Alex didn't come in to do it, and when it was brought up by Ms. Cook, she emailed me and told me what was happening, and it was off school grounds, so it's out of my control, and she did talk to Pearson about.
Are you aware that there are text messages happening on the school grounds?
It is not allowed to be happening on school grounds, so in which case they would have been breaking the school rules.
Did you have any prior knowledge of Alex's situation before she came in and talked to Mrs. Cook?
Mr.
Cook?
No.
Have you had any other bullying incidents with staff?
Yes.
Why did you address that bullying situation?
It was stunting the teacher's ability to work, and it was required of her to do so, and it would be fair to just fire her rather than addressing the situation as a friend.
Are you aware that Alex's grades dropped when she was being bullied?
Yes.
Are you aware that they are now much better at KHS St. Joseph's Academy?
So I've heard, yes.
Is there a reason that you didn't address that bullying situation as it affected her performance versus the teacher's performance.
Since becoming aware of the situation, it was only presented to us once, and we couldn't follow through with it as it was only reported once. But she was called in to deal with the problem of her grades dropping and her low attendance at school, and it was just brought to our attention there. And then about how it was off school grounds.
Are you aware that there are more than just CJ Pearson that was bullying Alex?
Yes.
Are you aware that a teacher also joined in on this? Mockery of Alex.
No.
There was a teacher that was, okay, well, I wasn't actually thinking about this. No further questions.
Okay, thank you very much. Did you wish to redirect? Does the defense wish to redirect?
Yes.
You may proceed.
So, were you aware that the situation was that bad and serious between Pearson and Billings?
I did not know about how serious the situation was until Ms. Francis stormed into my house.
And how many students are at your school?
Yeah, 5,000 students at the meeting.
And given the large number, do you think that you handled the situation adequately and to the best of your ability?
It is a large number of students, and we try our very best to take care of all of them and see through their bullying. And when Alex came in, we hoped she would come in again if the problem continued, but we did not get to see her again to address the situation properly.
Okay. Thank you. You may step down. And does the defense have any further witnesses for their case? Who are you calling to the stand?
CJ
Pearson, please come to the stand. Do you promise to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth? You may proceed with your questions.
Can you describe your first meeting with the defense?
I met her at freshman orientation for the first time, and we did become friends, and then later I met up with her at the Norfolk hangout.
Were you the only student?
I was not. There were many students also posting on MySpace and text messaging.
What has this trial done to your chances as a teacher?
This trial has almost completely ruined my chances with all of the newspaper articles, and it's going to be very difficult to put this behind me.
Were you aware of your effect on?
I was not aware. She never told me how it was affecting her, and she never told me to stop at all.
Objection, hold on, let me think about this. Okay, what would be the objection where they're telling the wrong fact?
The wrong fact?
Like they're not telling the truth?
What she's saying you don't feel goes with what her witness statement said, is that correct?
Well, in the evidence, it's the text messaging exhibit
Okay, so here's what you do. We go ahead and let the defense go down, and then when you question her, you have her read that evidence on the stand and then ask her why what she said is different than what the evidence says. That's how you do it. If you guys want to split the cross-examination, you can split the cross-examination too. Like, if you want to just deal with that part and then you do your normal cross-examination questions, you guys can split that if you would like to.
Okay. Okay.
And you can go ahead and go down. So there's really no objection, so it's overruled. It gets taken care of on cross examination.
Yeah, but I still have to.
Unless
you need me. Where are you going,
Rachel?
You know, I
need to
have an
appointment.
Okay. This is a big mess.
You may proceed with your cross examination questions. I believe Exhibit B has been submitted, is that correct?
Yes.
Yes, B has already been submitted. You may ask questions about Exhibit B.
In Exhibit B, it wasn't only you, but was everything... did you create a fake account stating ID Alex? Was it just you posting things? No.
And switch lawyers?
Yep. You may continue with the cross-examination.
Are you the key contributor, or the main contributor, would you say, to the I Hate Alex Billings page?
I am the...
Why did you create this MySpace page?
I was just getting my opinion out on how I felt about it.
Are you aware of the extent that your opinion has affected Alex Billings?
No, I was not aware of that.
We have exhibited the PTSD success.
I believe so.
Yeah. Are you aware that from these messages, Alex Billings has been diagnosed with post-traumatic stress disorder? Are you aware that Alex did tell you to stop in a text message that was sent back and forth between you two? In class, which is not only against your school policies. Are you aware that it's against your school policy? Then why would you do something?
Would the defense like to redirect the witness?
Just
Okay, thank you. You may step down. Okay. Does the defense have any further witnesses? Okay. At this time, we have still have two closing statements, but I know it's really difficult to try to ask you guys to close when it's been this close to hearing the arguments. And we also have juries who need, the jury needs to get statements in. Obviously, we were unable to have court yesterday due to the weather. So here's what we're going to do. For the jury, I want you guys to look at four different factors. One is whether or not the defendant is guilty of bullying the plaintiff. Okay. Two, is the school culpable in the bullying? Is the school responsible for it? Right. Three, does the defendant owe the plaintiff any money? Four, does the school owe the plaintiff any money?
Can you
okay.
Those last two?
Okay. So the last two.
Yeah.
Does the defendant owe the plaintiff any money, right, for the suffering, or does the school owe the plaintiff any money for tuition or pain and suffering, right? You can choose either to have them both be guilty of pain and suffering for the plaintiff, or you can split it. Or you can say they're both innocent of it, or you can split it to where one is guilty and the other one is not. So you can choose any of those options. If you say that the defense was not culpable, you could also find that the plaintiff has to pay the defense for their time in court. So that's also a possibility for you, and that's on the table. Yes, you may. So those will be the decisions that you'll need to make in preparing your 1 to 2 minute statement or your 1 to 2 minute speech that you will give the rest of the jury tomorrow. We will listen to closing arguments first, and you can make that part of your jury statement if you want to. But the thing is we're not going to have time really for you to prepare between, just because it's all in one class period. So what we'll do tomorrow is we'll have the closing statement by the plaintiff. We'll have the closing statement by the defendant. Okay, the two closing statements. Then the jury will go to the jury room. We will do the jury member speeches. They will come back with a verdict, and then by the end of class, we will have a verdict tomorrow. Okay, so the planning time, we have what, another 5 minutes or so? So planning.